Hi, welcome to Harmony with Su-Lynn, and in this tutorial we'll look at adding textures to paperless animation. I'll show you how to create new texture brushes and how to use the cutter node. So let's start. You'll need a design or paperless animation. I have my robin and we'll start with the body of the character. I've added a gradient for the colour. You can go to the multi-wheel and select gradient and choose your colour changes. Once we have the colour, let's make a new drawing by using the shortcut Command R and name it Texture. With the body texture layer selected, select the brush and then go to the tool properties. If you select dual tip and paper texture, you can try out some of those examples. I'm going to select tip 36 and hold down O, click and drag to increase the size of the brush. You can also make changes such as spacing, and you can see how that affects the quality of the brush. You can also change the hardness setting, and that is more or less what I'm looking for my texture brush. There's also roundness and angle, which you can play around with, and also at any point you can change your tip. Once you're happy with your brush, you can make a new brush by hitting the plus sign over here for new brush, name it, and hit OK. Once we've made our brush, we can select the color we'd like. I have some pre-made brushes, and I'm going to select that. Paint the texture on freely. You don't have to worry about staying within the lines because we'll take care of that later with the cutter node. Over here, you can see that some of the texture application has fallen outside the area of the body. So we're going to add a cutter to the texture drawing. The cutter node hides parts of a drawing, a group, or in this case, an effect. The cutter node is connected to the drawing and that will serve as the mat. And you can invert the cutter node's mat. The cutter is attached to the texture and now we can attach the body to the mat port and invert. And there we have the texture sitting inside the body area. We can add a peg and then add the rotation point. Now let's add a peg that connects both the body texture and the body so they move along together and call that the master body peg. We'll need to add a rotation point for that, but we can copy the coordinates of the rotation point from the body texture and just copy the values for the X and Y into the master peg. And now if we needed to move the body texture as the animation flows, we can do that because it has its own peg. But we can also select the master peg and move both the texture and the body together. So we can apply the same process for the front wing, the back wing, and the breast piece. Let's just make sure that everything is connected to one master peg for the robin, so that when we create the animated sequence, all the pieces can move together. And there we have it for the textures in the robin. You can repeat the process for the background as well. So on my background, I have these branches. We can make our own brushes for the texture we'd like. So first of all, make a drawing for the texture layer and give it a name. I've got foreground underscore texture. And now selected on the drawing texture, we can paint our texture onto our branch. I have a preset brush made for the branch texture. And I'm going to paint that on freely without worrying too much about staying within the lines or the area of the branch. Now let's add a cutter and connect the branch to the cutter. You can see I've also repeated the process for the snow as well, using the brush tool and the cutter node. Visit my tutorial on the brush tool for more details. And there we have it, adding beautiful textures to our paperless animation. See you next time.